Hello there, HBI Guys Model Workshop here, back with a review on the brand new workbench. If you watch one of my tool reviews, you'll see that we're going to take a look at some stuff on this new workbench. The reason being is I can leave the model bench that you're so used to seeing with that cutting pad on there, and I'll still do reviews and builds on there, but I can leave that for plastic model and RC model building, and I can use this workbench on the side, this much larger workbench on the side, for woodworking projects and tool reviews and kit reviews, because I have a lot more room. And even though it's a little off topic, you can see lots more room to display stuff when I do reviews. So this is probably going to work out way better for us folks and be able to see things a lot nicer. This is AMT's re-release of the Lil Hot Dogger with Droopy Dog the Bone Ranger, you can see on there. And this is a kit I don't even know existed. I do know about some older kits, but I wasn't around way back in the day when these kits first came out, so I never even heard about it. And I was cruising Tower Hobby's website and noticed that this was in the, that was coming in soon. So I put it on a reminder, I got an email that it was available, and I picked it up, and I'm really happy I did. Now, a lot of the purists aren't a big fan of this kit, aren't a fan of any of these fantasy kits, because they just can't let their mind enjoy a fantasy. But that's what this kit is. It's not a real vehicle. Very little about this would actually work in the real world, and who cares? It's a really cool plastic kit, and you're going to see that, and you're probably going to want it, even if you didn't think it was that cool looking on the box. Now, we can take a look at the cool retro box art from AMT, and you can see that they've gone and replicated the box art very nicely in that old style. I don't know a lot about the history of this kit, but I'm guessing it must have come out in the 60s or 70s based on the way it looks. On the box, they tell you a lot of the accessories that are going to be included. Giant slicks, fire hydrant, kitty catcher, dog net, T-bone radiator cap, bone handle shifter. Everything's got a exact theme. Doggy dish, there's Droopy Dog on the lower left. Pet roll tank, get it? Petrol, pet roll tank. I kill me. Pointer steering wheel. Bowser bench seat. I mean, you know, and then those wheels. Of course, this box in the old style, it says bite-sized slicks, and they have a Goodyear label on there, but we'll see that that's a little different on this one. On the back of the box, of course, is the normal AMT Round 2 parts list on the back. They go all out for these kits, and I'm really glad they do. On the other side of the box, on the other large box end, just shows you a buildup of the chassis and the cab and the engine. Once again, this is a fantasy vehicle, so suspend reality for a little bit while you enjoy this model kit. The instruction manual is standard AMT, and we can look at that here. You can see that it has your build your engine first. Now, I didn't look in here. I didn't read the manual to see exactly what kind of engine it is. It looks like a small block. I would guess, you know, small block Chevy or Ford. But I don't know exactly what kind of engine or if it's even modeled after a real engine besides they just threw a V8 in from another kit. You can see the assembly here. The slicks are two-piece. The wheels are two-piece. The front wheels are two-piece with a single-piece skinny. Then you can see they build the interior massively detailed, as you can see. About four parts go into your interior and floorboard. Then you get into the chassis. One large piece frame with all the different chrome accessories and engine in there. It's not an extremely complicated kit. The only part that may give you any issues would be building the body and lining it up so it's square. But if you use a small wood jig, if you staple some small pieces of wood together to square up the body, you shouldn't have any issues, or just take your time. It should fall together quite nicely. There are a lot of other paper goods in this kit. One thing I love that Round 2 does is they give you a copy of the box in the box on all their retro kits. And I'm so glad they do that. You don't have to save the, you know, the big box. You don't have to save this anymore because it looks so cool and you just wanted to save it. They take up a lot of space. This can just be, the model can just be displayed in the display case with the retro box art, and you can crush the other box and send it out for recycling. I'm so glad they put those in their kits. Other companies don't bother. Also inside this kit, a little feature, I don't know if this came with the original or not, but it does come with this one, is a cardboard display. And you can see all the different things here. They've got fire hydrants and everything pops out and turns into 3D, and a sidewalk. They've got the sweet AMT logo. They've just got a box support. They've got a little doggy here running away. And then they've got the street surface with the manhole cover, and this will be the front of your display where it'll fold down. Dig the Dogger from the Cats at AMT. The Show Rod Revival is here. How awesome is that? And then this folds up in the back. There's instructions on the back of the thing to tell you how to fold it all up. What a sweet display that's going to make for this little kit. It just adds even more. And especially if you like to go to model shows, even if you don't win anything, when you have something like this on display, you can see it's just going to be so much cooler. So that's all in the box. No, you know, no extra charge. The price I paid for this was under $25. I think it was like $21.95, $22.49, somewhere around there. I did get it at Tower, so you can go on there and search it there. The beautiful decal sheet included is just stunning. So many different options, so many different ideas. You've got decals on there for the Mutt Hut, the Holiday Inn, the Puppy Power, the Lil Hot Dogger. Well, 400 cubic inch. I guess we know what kind of motor is in there now because of the decals. The Pooch Pincher, the Dog Nabbit, the Rabid Transit. So they've got, well, now wait a minute. They've got 400 cubic inch here. They've got in white 375. So I think it's just a fantasy engine. They've got the Wiener Wagon, the Hound Pound. Oh my lord. Look at that. Canine Kennel Club. There's a million options for this thing. And what's really cool is you get to keep all these decals that you don't use and use it on something else. Now you can see it's got lettering for the big tires. And it's got paw prints. It's got Doggone. Male, of course, with the shoes. You put that on the driver's seat, it says Sit Good Boy. All different. Tons of options. Nothing you can't do with that decal sheet. You can pause the video right there. Zoom in and take a look at all that stuff. So there's quite a few options there. Now, the first thing I'll show you is the tires. Now, you won't be having to use those tire decals, so you can save those for another project, a little kitschy project if you want, because take a look at those tires. Now, these are your front tires, your skinnies, and they're a little out of round because of the way they're molded, but once you put those in the wheel itself, those will come out perfect. They're not going to have any issues with those at all. The slicks themselves are vinyl. They're not plastic, and they are two-piece, but check it out. They're pad printed with their cool little slogan, the Greyhound Grippers K9. Is that not the coolest? And they are two-piece, but they go together so nice. They just, like that, you can hear it kind of pop together. You're not going to have any problems with that. Check it out. That's so sweet, and they are soft vinyl. Squish, 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 squish. Definitely worth the price of admission on that one. So you're going to be able to save all those decals for something else. You're not going to have to put them anywhere else or worry about them. Now let's take a look at the chrome. I did take the chrome out of the box, and you get more than one chrome tree with this. You actually get three big chrome trees. They were all about the shiny stuff on these fantasy kits. You can see all your different accessories in here, that giant lock. You got your what looks like lights. I can't really tell. The chrome's so shiny in the camera. You got your steering wheel. You got your dog net here. Some of this stuff, of course, you're going to want to strip before you use it. Ooh, shiny. You can see part of my workshop, part of the lighting on there. That's really nice chrome. You've got your dog bone shifter. Isn't that neat? Everything's a big play on a pun. They should call these kits pun kits. Because it's fun, but it's a pun. Oh. I should go into comedy and I'd starve to death. There's one of your rear wheels. You can see it's two-piece, real thick. Nice deep chrome in there. A little black wash or some dull coat will make the chrome look far more realistic. Or you can leave it just as it is because it is a fantasy kit. Even on the fantasy kits, I would prefer to dull down the chrome a little bit so it doesn't look as toyish. There's your gorgeous headers. This thing was real, it would be insanely loud. That's the two smaller chrome trees, and this is the big, massive one. Look at all that stuff. Wow. There's your other wheel. There's your traction bars, your springs, radiator, bumper, fan. Oil pan, look at the stacks on that motor. All right. Got your rear end. That's a big pumpkin back there. Then you've got some of your other linkages. And it looks like these are your big headlight buckets there and there. So nice looking. Great job on the chrome. I don't see any issues. I don't see any yellowed areas on there. Right here in the bag is the windshield parts. You can see those are nice and clear and flat with your headlights, or they give you the option of going blue, because that was the thing back when this kit was made, so you do have the option, and then the red taillights. So it's very nice that they include those. Let's move it up a little bit. Get that camera something to focus on. That bamboo's starting to make it freak out. This bag of parts here, we'll just kind of dump them out in front of you. And we'll move it down a little bit. Here's your frame. Nothing fancy about that whatsoever, but it is straight. And put it on the table. And it's straight. So you're not going to have any problems with that. Nothing fancy, extremely basic. Hot rod frame for the fantasy vehicle. On this tree here is your engine. Your 375 or your 400, whatever you decide to call it. Very simple, not a huge amount of parts, enough to make it look nice. Got a battery there even. Intake, heads, valve covers are on the chrome tree, remember. Enough to make it a fun kit, nothing amazing. We've got some structural parts here. These look like the rear doors of the cabin, the pound on the back of the wagon. And then there's your interior floor. You can see the 2 foot marks there. And then you just got some basic structural parts here. A little bit of a real light wood grain on there. I don't think the camera's going to pick that up at all. And then here is Droopy Dog. He's in 2 halves. But he's a cool guy. See? Put him together, paint him up. He's going to look neat in that little diorama. Let's look at the last set of plastic parts. Slide those off here. Whoa! And this is the remainder of the kit right here. This is all that's left in there. You can see it's a low parts count, high fun count. There's one of your doors or side doors on the pound. This must be the back. So you can see the size that the cab's going to be, 4 fingers wide. And you've got your bone seat. You've got your netting and your side doors and windows. And obviously this will be like this. So this is where the driver will go in. You see him hanging out of that in the box right there. And then you've got the overhang, the little overhang for the front. That is that multicolored thing right there. And then the seat. We saw the seat and the directions. Nice detail on there, and then the roof. So you can paint it as you wish. You can decal it, not decal it. You can do whatever you want with it. It is a fantasy kit, so you really can't build it wrong. The Lil Hot Dogger from AMT. Do I recommend this kit? Highly, if you're into fun. If you're into scale realism, pass it up and spend your money on something else. But if you want to have some fun, I bet you could easily build this in a weekend, get it painted in a couple days, detail it up. It's going to be a great looking kit with that display base. It sends it over the top. It's worth every single penny. I think you should pick it up, and thanks for watching.